Welcome back, students. Let us continue with the revision of economics lesson number 1, development. Today, in this video, we are going to learn about income and some other criteria to compare the development of countries. Let's begin. Students, observe this table carefully. Here, now we are going to compare 3 states. Okay, Haryana, Kerala and Bihar in terms of per capita income. Okay, so for the year 2015 and 16, the per capita income of Haryana was 1,62,034. For Kerala, it was 1,40,190. Whereas for Bihar, it was just 31,454. So, if we compare the development of these 3 states on the basis of per capita income, then of course Haryana ranks first. Isn't it, students? Why? Because its per capita income for the year 2015 to 16 was 1,62,034. Isn't it? Okay. Now, let us compare these 3 states again on the basis of some other criteria. Other criteria like infant mortality rate, literacy rate and net attendance ratio. Okay, and you all are aware about infant mortality rate, literacy rate and net attendance ratio. Isn't it? We are already learnt about these terms. Now let's start comparing these 3 states. Haryana's infant mortality rate in the year 2016 was 33, Kerala 10 and Bihar 38. Now if you see, the infant mortality rate of Kerala was low, right? And it is a good indicator of development. Now let us see the literacy rate of Haryana in the year 2011. It was 82, Kerala 94, okay, and Bihar it was 62. Now if you compare these 3 states as per the literacy rate, then of course Kerala ranks first. In terms of infant mortality rate also, Kerala ranks first. And in the terms of literacy rate also, Kerala ranks first. Now let us see the net attendance ratio. Okay, net attendance ratio of Haryana for the year 2013 to 14 was 61, Kerala 83 and Bihar 43. Again, Kerala ranks first because its net attendance ratio was 83 for the year 2013 to 14. I hope you all have understood. Let us proceed further. Public activities. Money in your pocket cannot buy all the goods and services that you may need to live well. Isn't it, students? With the help of money, we cannot buy all the goods and services that we need to live well. For example, a pollution-free environment, unadulterated medicines, protection from infectious diseases, etc. Can we buy a pollution-free environment, unadulterated medicines? No. Can we be protected from infectious diseases with the help of money? No. So, we can conclude that money in our pocket cannot buy all the goods and services that we need to live well. I hope it is clear. Kerala has low infant mortality rate. Students, do you know why Kerala has low infant mortality rate? Yes, because it has adequate provision of basic health and educational facilities. Now just tell me, if a state has low infant mortality rate, is it a good indicator of development? Yes, it is. The state should have low infant mortality rate to be developed. okay, and Kerala has low infant mortality rate. Why? Because it has adequate provision of basic health and educational facilities. Okay. Similarly, in some states, the public distribution system functions well. And the areas where the public distribution system functions well, we can find the people are healthy. Okay, and their nutritional status is better. Okay, health and nutritional status of people in such states. In which states? Yes, where the PDS functions well, where the public distribution system functions well, okay, is certainly likely to be better. Now let us talk about body mass index. One way to find out if we are nourished is to calculate what is called body mass index. So with the help of body mass index, we can come to know whether we are nourished or undernourished. Okay. So now let us see the steps we need to follow to calculate body mass index. Take the weight in kilograms, then take the height in meters. If the height is in centimeters, you need to convert it into meters. Divide the weight by the square of the height. So, how to calculate body mass index? We need to divide the weight of a person by the square of the person's height. Is that clear, students? If the BMI of a person is below 18.5, it means the person is underweight. If the BMI is between 18.5 to 24.9, it means the person is healthy. If the BMI is between 25 to 29.9, it means the person is overweight. And if the BMI is 30 or greater than that, the person is obese. Okay, students. Students, here is a question for you. A man weighs 86 kilograms and is 1.89 meters tall. Calculate his BMI. So when you calculate the BMI of this person, you get the answer as 24.1. Okay. It means this person is nourished. Why? Because the BMI of this person is between 18.5 to 24.9. I hope you all have understood about this. Now let us proceed further. Now we are going to talk about Human Development Index. Okay. Human Development Index, published by United Nations Development Program, compares countries based on the educational levels of the people, their health status, and per capita income. It would be interesting to look at certain relevant data regarding India and its neighbors from Human Development Report 2018. Students, just have a look at this table given. Here we can see gross national income of India in the year 2011 was 6,353. Life expectancy at birth in the year 2017 was 68.8. Mean years of schooling of people aged 25 and above in the year 2017 was 6.4. And the HDI rank in the world in the year 2018 was 130. Okay. Now, a small country in our neighborhood, Sri Lanka, is much ahead of India in every respect. Let's see. If you just go through the gross national income of Sri Lanka in the year 2011, it was 11,326. Isn't it? More than India. And if you see the life expectancy at birth, it was 75.5, more than India. Mean years of schooling of people aged 25 and above in the year 2017, it was 10.9. Again, it was more than India. So, we can conclude that Sri Lanka is much ahead of India in every respect. And do you know, students, the HDI rank of Sri Lanka in the world in the year 2018? Yes, it was 76. Okay. Now, Nepal has half the per capita income of India. Yet, it is not far behind India in life expectancy and literacy level. Students, just have a look at this table once again. Here you will find Nepal, which has half the per capita income of India. Yet, it is not far behind India in life expectancy and literacy levels. So, I hope you have understood this. Now, let us proceed further with sustainable development. Students, what is sustainable development? Yes, sustainable development is development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their own needs. Sustainability of development. Since the second half of the 20th century, a number of scientists have been warning that the present type and levels of development are not sustainable. Students, why is it so? Because in the name of development, natural resources are exploited at a fast rate, leading to their depletion. Renewable resources like groundwater are replenished by nature. Replenished means they can be filled again. However, even these resources may be overused. Hence, we must use it carefully. Non-renewable resources cannot be replenished as they have a fixed stock on earth. Non-renewable resources get depleted, they get exhausted, they cannot be replenished or they cannot be renewed again. We do discover new resources, but over time, even this will get exhausted. So, even if we discover new resources, over time, it will get exhausted. So, what we need to do? Yes, we need to use the resources wisely. I hope it is clear. Now, here is a question for you based on assertion and reason. You are familiar with this type of question, right? Because already this type of question was asked in your first unit test. Okay, now let us read the question. Assertion. Since the second half of the 20th century, scientists have been warning that the type and levels of development are not sustainable. Reason? In the name of development, natural resources are exploited at a fast rate, leading to their depletion. Now let us see the options. Option A. Both A and R are true, and R is a correct explanation of A. Option B. Both A and R are true, but R is not the correct explanation of A. Option C. A is true, but R is false. Option D. A is false, but R is true. Let us read the question once again. Assertion. Since the second half of the 20th century, scientists have been warning that the type and levels of development are not sustainable. Is the statement correct? Yes, it's true. Let us read the reason. In the name of development, natural resources are exploited at a fast rate, leading to their depletion. Is this statement correct? Yes. So both are correct. Assertion and reason, both are correct. Now let us find out whether the reason given is the correct reason for the assertion. Yes, the reason given is the correct reason for the assertion. So, the option A, that is both A and R are true, and R is the correct explanation of A, is correct. Is that clear, students? Very good. Now, let us discuss the paper pattern for essay 1 exam. Okay, you will have 4 sections. Section A, Section B, Section C and Section D. Okay. Under Section A, you will have objectives. Now, under objectives, you may have match the following. Okay. Answer in one sentence. Picture based questions. Complete the following table. MCQs, true or false, find the incorrect option. Arrange the following incorrect sequence, assertion and reason. So all these will come under objectives. Is that clear? Under section B, you will have short answer type questions as well as passage based questions. Okay. Here the passage will be a short one. It would be of 3 marks. You will have 3 questions carrying 1 mark each. Now let us find out the questions which will be asked under section C. Long answer type questions will be asked. Okay, long answer type questions, as well as you will have a long passage. 3 questions, 1 question for 1 mark and the other 2 questions for 2 marks each. Is that clear, students? And under section D, you will have maps. Okay, maps of history as well as geography. So I hope you have understood about the paper pattern of essays for essay 1 exam. Don't just rely on revision videos or the notes that we have sent to you. You need to read the textbooks thoroughly. Okay. So students, all the best for your exams. Meet you after the exam. Bye and take care.